Heavy rain made you think about your flood insurance and how glad you are that you have it. You actually may not. The National Flood Insurance Program, as well as other programs, expired at 11:59 Sunday night. My story is all new at 10. The federal government wants to overhaul the National Flood Insurance Program, but that overhaul includes rate hikes that some lawmakers want and others do not. With a lack of common ground, temporary extensions of the program have been authorized for years.
Until these two camps can come together and work something out, it's going to continually be extended for short periods of time.
Last Thursday, the Senate failed to act on a bill already passed by the House that would have extended the program another 30 days. Since they did not vote, it lapsed. And since most homes in New Orleans are in flood zones and by law must have flood insurance, problems arise.
It could cost you a house, it could cost you interest rate, because a lot of people have a rate lock for a certain period of time.
Kelly Wright is a real estate agent with Latter & Blum. She knows the program will eventually be reauthorized, probably later this week, but that doesn't help her clients today.
If their house is selling and they have a time, so they have to move into their new house the next day or the same day, suddenly they don't have a place to live. The lenders are going nuts. The title attorneys are going nuts.
And it's no field day for insurance agents either.
It's the in limbo part. The last couple of extensions have all been extended. Although it's down to the wire, they've all been extended before the deadline. And for some reason, this was missed. Congress adjourned without reauthorizing it, and we're in a state of limbo.
So here's what this boils down to tonight. As long as the National Flood Insurance Program is on what they're calling a hiatus, new policies cannot be issued, coverage on existing policies cannot be increased, and renewals cannot be issued unless Congress reauthorizes it, which again they do expect to happen sometime this week with that vote. There are 5.6 million flood insurance policyholders across the U.S.